Hey, good morning, church. So good to see you for the second day of our 21 days of prayer. Could I ask you to stand with us? And I know it's early, but is anybody just excited to be in God's presence this morning? Could you join me in welcoming those that are tuning in online and just put your hands together for them? We're so glad y'all are here. Yeah, thank you for joining in with us and just participating in this time. You know, I just want to make sure as we kind of kick off this 6 a.m. time, it's different getting up this early and being here this early on a weekday morning. But don't let it be about our feelings, but about the one that we're here to pray to and just to trust in. And I want to ask you, if you would, just let's do what the Word of God says. Let's enter His courts with thanksgiving in our hearts. And enter His courts with praise. And I believe that God is worthy of our praise any time of day. Amen. And so we're just going to kick off this morning worshiping Him. Would you just join me in saying a quick prayer, and then they're going to lead us in song. God, we love You, and we're here because of You. Holy Spirit, I just ask for You to lead this time, guide our hearts. In the name of Jesus, I pray. And all God's people said, amen. Come on, church, let's sing out to God this morning.
Sing it out. So come, let us worship our King.
Yes. Amen. You can be seated for just a moment, but don't fall asleep while you're being seated. I know it's a temptation this early, but man, God is so good and He is so worthy of our praise. And I really am expectant that during these 21 days that God is just going to do incredible things through just your efforts, through our time. I believe that God rewards just this time that we set aside. You know, it's kind of crazy how many things are going on in the world all at once. Do you sometimes feel like it's hard to keep up? Like you're like, I don't know which bad thing to focus on today. And so why not? Let's not focus on the bad. Let's focus on the God who is above it all. And that's what I really want to challenge us and just call the church to during this 21 days. I guess if you would say we have kind of an overriding theme, it's simply the theme of great faith. And I'm going to share some things with today being our first time to gather together, especially for those new. We've actually got a group of folks watching over in Vernon. They're at the office space there in Vernon. One more time, would you just show some love and appreciation to our Vernon family? We're so excited about what God is doing over there. And I wanted to share with you some scripture that it's not on your daily prayer focus, and I'll just kind of give you an overview of what the day will look like and just how these mornings will kind of flow, just so that we can get out of the way and let God have His way. I do want to make sure that you're equipped if you need it, if you want it. We've got just some resources to be put to use, hopefully. And the first one is our Pray First prayer guide. And some people have got the older model, and you know what? It works just as well. But if yours is falling apart or you've lost it, you're welcome to get another one. But you may want to utilize this, especially later on during the morning. We're going to dismiss to just a time of personal prayer. And you may have realized this. The enemy doesn't like it for the church to pray. And so you will find your mind sometimes attacked. You'll be trying to figure out how to stay focused on things. And this prayer guide is a wonderful tool, a wonderful resource. So please take one and utilize that as you need. It's got just great examples of prayer as taught by Jesus right out of Scripture, and then other scriptural models like the tabernacle prayer. It's got where you can just pray the Word of God, just praying Scripture. So wherever the Lord leads you, that might be a great resource during your personal time. But over the course of these 3 weeks, every week there's going to be kind of a main theme of the week. And if you don't have one, I encourage you to get one of our 21 days of prayer, daily prayer focus sheets. These will be available to download on the website later today at lakeviewpeople.com/prayer. Or else we've got a lot of them already printed out on the information table and the entry table. But each week has a big theme, and then we're going to have a daily prayer focus as well. You may notice that every Sunday we treat our worship services as our gathering for the day. And on those days, we pray specifically over our church services. We pray specifically over the ministries that God has called us to steward. But all throughout the week, Monday through Friday at 6 a.m., and then Saturday at 9 a.m., we'll have a daily focus too. Because I believe, and the reason I believe it is the Word of God says it, I believe it's powerful when we come into agreement in prayer. Anybody believe that this morning? And so today I just want to share with you just a few moments from the Word of God about this topic of great faith. First, I want to speak to you from Hebrews chapter 1. This would be, I guess, our theme verse of Scriptures. It's Hebrews chapter 1, verse 1, and then I'm also going to read verse 6. This is out of the New Living Translation, and it says, "Faith shows the reality of what we hope for. It is the evidence of things we cannot see." Faith is a powerful force. And faith is important to the Lord, as it says in Hebrews 11:6, that same chapter, it says, "And it is impossible to please God without faith." So I just want to encourage you, if you're like, man, I'm praying about something, but I don't even know how God could answer that, that's just the kind of prayers he's liking the most, is those that require faith in Him. Not faith in our own abilities or our own understanding, but faith in Jesus. And so pray this morning just with an expectancy, because it actually tells us anyone who wants to come to God must believe that God exists and that He rewards. Somebody say rewards. So as you pray, will you know that you are serving a God who rewards those who sincerely seek Him? And look, I think you would have a hard time faking that you're really trying to seek God if you would take time to be up here this early. There'd be a lot easier ways of faking it, I would just say that. So I believe the Lord is going to reward our time and our effort. Just being, you know, unified in just wanting to seek God together. I can't wait to see what we're going to find in the Lord as we do that. Now, I told you that each day there's going to be a prayer focus. It's not the only thing that we're going to pray about that day. I want you to pray here in a little while. Hannah's going to lead us in another song here in just a few moments. And then we're going to have just a time of personal prayer where you need to find your prayer posture. If you like to kneel, if you like to just stay seated or stand, or some people pace. I do want to challenge you. I want to ask you, just as your pastor, that during that time of personal prayer, as we're seeking for great faith, I want to ask you just to increase your boldness. And as you feel led, I'm calling on the church, will you actually pray your prayers out loud? And that doesn't mean you got to air personal business. We're going to have the music up where it's just be between you and God. But can I tell you, we're here together, and it's encouraging to me to see other people coming and praying. And I'm tired of the enemy getting to have all the say in this world. Let's let the people of God lift up their voice unto the Lord and be bold in our prayer life. And let's be bold just in our everyday life. So I just want to encourage you in that way. And this morning's focus, this day two prayer focus, we gathered together yesterday to kick off 21 days. But today the focus is simply a faith for salvation. And this first week is all going to be about faith in God. Next week will be faith in our lives, and the final week will be faith in our worlds. But I want to make sure we have some things settled in our relationship with God, because it impacts everything else that we do. And when it comes to faith for salvation, Ephesians chapter 2, verses 8 and 9 says, "For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourselves." So, church, while we're up here early and we're praying together, know that the main work and the main responsibility doesn't rest on our shoulders. Jesus already bore it all on His shoulders and on the cross. It is a gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast. And the reason today's focus is faith for salvation is I believe this is the most important kind of faith that we can have, is faith in Jesus Christ as our Savior and Lord. Because you know what? If our eternity is secure in Jesus, everything else is secondary to that. And so I want us to feel settled. I want us to be secure in who we are in Christ and the hope that we have in Him. Jesus actually said, and this is not in your notes or in the prayer focus, but I wanted to read from Luke chapter 10 what happened and some important things Jesus said about salvation. It says, "The 72 returned with joy and said, 'Lord, even the demons submit to us in your name.' And Jesus replied, 'I saw Satan fall like lightning.'" He's letting them know, look, I've seen some stuff. You've seen demons, you know, submit to my name. I saw Satan get kicked out of heaven. And then in verse 19, he says, "I have given you authority to trample on snakes and scorpions and to overcome all the power of the enemy. Nothing will harm you." Does anybody believe that what Jesus said is true? So knowing all that, listen to what he says in verse 20. "However, do not rejoice that the spirits submit to you, but rejoice that your names are written in heaven." All that other stuff is secondary to just having faith in our Savior and Lord. And the challenge that I want to lay before you this morning is just kind of the prayer nugget, I guess, if I could leave you with, is as you enter a personal time of prayer, let it just begin at the foot of the cross. If you focus first on who Jesus is and what He's already done for us, man, anything you ask after that doesn't seem so big, doesn't seem so impossible. When you realize, to me, well, I just believe it to be true. I believe the greatest miracle ever is salvation. That our whole eternity is changed just by faith in Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. And I think one of the greatest psalms, maybe one of the greatest chapters in the Bible, is Psalm 103. And I just want to read this before Hannah leads us, because it kind of talks about the benefits just of trusting in Jesus for your salvation. Do you know you get bonus benefits just by trusting in God. It says, praise the Lord, my soul. In all my inmost being, praise his holy name. It says, praise the Lord, my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Listen to what we have access to. These are promises of God written down in the Word of God so we could hold on to them forever. It says in verse 3, who forgives all your sins. Aren't you glad Jesus has forgiven all of our sins, past, present, and future? They're covered by the blood of Jesus Christ. But that's not all, folks. This is not an infomercial, but that's not all. It also says, and he heals all your disease. So please don't consider me selfish, but as I'm thanking Jesus for my salvation, I'm going to thank Jesus for my healing. That if we can trust him with our eternal soul, I can sure trust him to kick aside any disease. He says he heals all disease. There is not any disease whose name is greater than the name of Jesus. So if you need healing this morning, start at the foot of the cross, but don't forget all those benefits that come with what Jesus did on the cross. It goes on to say, who redeems your life from the pit and crowns you with love and compassion. This one is really personal to me. Who satisfies your desires with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. Thank you, Jesus, for all of your benefits. These are just a few, but these are pretty great. Amen. So I want to ask if you would to stand again, and let's just put our focus where the focus needs to be, on how good Jesus is. And Hannah's going to lead us in just a song singing about the goodness of God.
Okay.
Amen. Isn't God so good? He always is, no matter what it feels like or looks like. I'm about to dismiss us to a time of personal prayer. And to those on the live stream, please don't log off or leave. It'll just go to kind of a video screen with some background music for about 15 to 20 minutes. But then we're going to come back. Hannah's going to lead us back into song at the end of this time. And we're going to pray corporately together at the end, because again, I just believe in the power of praying in agreement. But I wanted to let you know, if you've got any prayer needs, we've got connection cards laid out across the stage, or they're in all the seat pockets around you as well. Please take time to fill out prayer requests if you've got them, and you can just leave them on the steps or put them on the offering boxes, whatever you're most comfortable with. And we're just going to accumulate those over these 21 days. And to those of you watching online, you can submit your prayer requests either right in the comments on this live stream video, or you can go to the website, lakeviewpeople.com/prayer. And I'm believing for miracles. Anybody got situations it would take a miracle for it to change? That's the kind of God we serve. We serve a miracle working God. So I'm going to just ask you at this time, again, will you pray personally, but will you lift your voice unto the Lord? Let's just let this house be filled with just the prayers of faith unto the Lord. And they're going to turn us on some music. And would you just find your place, or if you like to pace around kind of like I do, that's fine too. And let's spend some time just in the presence of God. Amen.
Anybody testify of that? God's been good to you. Could you lift up just your voice in praise? Could we praise the Lord in this place this morning? Thank you, Jesus, for all you've done and all that you continue to do. Church, I'm going to just switch things up slightly from what we maybe have done in the past. And I'm going to ask you, if you would, to gather with me just here. Just come close as you can. You don't have to cram in, but just if we could just be together for these final few minutes just to pray together corporately. And I just want to thank Hannah for leading us into the presence of God this morning, and for Michael and Jennifer helping her out, and John being here. Y'all, they've been here way before we got here. And you know what? Before they even got here, the Lord's presence is here. And we just come into agreement now with His presence. I just want us to spend some time praying together corporately, just in agreement. And so don't be shy. If y'all will just come around here too, so I can kind of see some of you. Will you just join me just as Hannah continues to play? We know God has been good to us, and so He's not going to stop now. You know, it's not like God was good yesterday and now He's not good today. And so whatever needs that we have, you know, I wanted to make sure before we asked God for anything that we thanked Him for everything. And I believe we've done that. We've just, again, gone to the foot of the cross and just walked through all that Jesus has done. So now, I'm reminded of the account in Scripture about the centurion soldier who came to Jesus and wanted prayer for his servant. Do y'all remember that Scripture in the Bible? And he said, hey, I'll go with you. And the soldier said, you don't even have to come to my house. Just say the word. Do you know that's only one of two places in the New Testament that the phrase, kind of the key theme that we're aiming for, which is great faith, it's one of only two times you'll see that term used in the New Testament. Jesus said, greater faith I have not seen in all of Israel. And did you know both the times that it says great faith, it's not a Jewish descent person that is referenced. It's just an ordinary person like us. You know, I'm so thankful for God's people, and I'm thankful that we're grafted into being God's people. So we can stand on the same promises of God that God makes to Israel because we're grafted in. And I don't know about you, but I need the promises of God, and I want to believe for them and receive for them. So if you're praying for your family, we're going to come into agreement with you for salvation for your household. If you're praying for your marriage, we're going to come into agreement with you. If you're praying for health in your body, we're going to come into agreement with you. We're just going to pray. I'm just going to pray as the Spirit leads, and I'm going to ask you to do the same. Let's just pray together, lift our hearts unto the Lord, but believe that God is able. And His goodness, you know, that word where it talks about surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life. That term there, follow me, actually says it's chasing after you. Sometimes we just need to be still and know that He is God. And so again, don't feel like stressed, like, oh, if I don't say the exact right thing, or what if I don't do this? Just rest in trusting Jesus. It's all about Jesus. Amen? Amen. Would you just join me in praying unto the Lord right now? Father, right now with these in the building and those watching online, we just join our hearts. We come into agreement together. We come in unity with one another, God. And as they're lifting up their needs to you, I believe that you love these people even more than I do. And I know I love them a lot. So you must really, really love us, God. And we can trust that you hear our hearts. God, I pray over anyone that is brokenhearted among us, or those tuning in, those that are watching this live or later, let them know, let them hear your voice saying that you love them, that you forgive them, and that you are restoring them. You're making them new. They are not who they used to be in the name of Jesus. So let anybody struggling with self-doubt or self-esteem be lifted up. Thank you again for the promises of Psalm 103 that you forgive all our sins, you heal our disease, you redeem us from the pit, you crown us with love and compassion, and you satisfy our desires with good things. And I just want to stand on those promises right now, God. We do believe that you have forgiven all of our sins. Would you just receive that again, just gratitude unto God that your sins are forgiven. You have been made whole. You have been made clean. We are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. And if you're struggling with any kind of doubt, would you just say that, personalize it. I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. So it was never about us or our abilities. It's about Jesus. So we trust in you. And God's word says that the effectual, fervent prayer of the righteous, you know what it says, it availeth much. That's King James Version for it's powerful and effective. It does a lot of good. And so God, as we are righteous, not out of self-righteousness, but as we humble ourselves before you and pray, I believe your word that when your people humble themselves and pray, that you hear us from heaven. We turn from our wickedness. We turn from our sins. We repent of that and we turn our life over to you. And God, I just thank you for your promise that you hear us right now, that you will heal our land. And so God, we stand in the gap over our schools as people are getting their kids ready to return to school. We just had tax-free weekend, Lord, and I'm just praying, God, that kids would trust you with their eternity, that this would be sin-free weekend, that people would just be forgiven of their sins as they put their faith in Jesus Christ, that they would live their life for you. I pray over teachers. I pray over administrators, the pressures of leading those kids. I pray over families like my own who are homeschooled, that they feel that responsibility. Thank you for moms and dads that invest that in their kids, Lord. And I pray just blessings over all those that are teaching their kids, whether it's in public school, private school, at home, whatever the classroom, God, on the mission field, Lord, where kids are in orphanages, but they're getting their education as part of the work there in those orphanages. We pray over them, Lord, that you would have your hand upon them. I speak against this violence that has happened in schools, Lord. We pray just great protection. As we have great faith, we take a stand of protection over our children in this nation and in the world, God, that you would shut down any demon that would try to possess someone to take a gun into a school. We rebuke that in the name of Jesus. We call it out and we cast it out in Jesus' name. Protect our schools in our community, in our state, and in our nation. In the almighty name of Jesus Christ, protect our babies, God. Let your angels, your war angels, stand guard around our school campuses, around our households and our homes, around our churches, anywhere where the enemy would try to invade and attack. We speak protection over them, God. Raise us out of that pit of fear. Raise us out of that pit of feeling like, well, this is just what we have to accept. We don't accept it. We just accept only your will. Your will be done on earth and in our schools and in our homes and in our families, on earth as it is in heaven, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, I just want to thank you. I feel led right here, Holy Spirit, just to come into agreement as your word says, you forgive all our sins and heal all our disease. And if you need healing in your physical body right now, would you allow us just to come into agreement together with you as best you can, as you're comfortable to do it, even if you're watching online, would you do this just as an act of faith? Nothing magic about it, it's just an act of faith. Would you place your hand, if you've got pain in your body, if you need healing in a certain part of your body, would you just put your hand there? You are the hands and feet of Jesus. And we just come into agreement right now. Would you do that with me? And just pray in agreement with anybody that has need for healing. If it's in your body, if it's in your heart, if it's in your mind, I speak the healing power of Jesus in this place and flowing from this place. You know how sometimes you walk into a hospital and you can feel the sadness? It's almost like a spirit of sickness and disease. That's because there is a spirit of infirmity. But right now we cast that spirit away. We rebuke it in the name of Jesus. And I just pray for the Holy Spirit the healing Spirit of God to rest upon you right now. We believe with great faith, Lord, for your healing. That man said, Jesus, you don't even have to come to my house. You just say the word. So church, I want you to believe it is right, and it's good to lay hands on one another, and we do that all the time. But I want you to know you just need Jesus to touch you right where you're at. And I speak healing. It's not about a man or a woman. It's about the one who was on the cross, who took stripes on his back. And as you believe him for salvation, will you believe him for your healing right now? In the name of Jesus, I believe that pain is going. Pain is just having to be calmed. It's having to just quiet itself in the presence of Almighty God, in the presence of Jesus Christ. Arthritis is not stronger than Jesus. Cancer is not stronger than Jesus. Heart disease, diabetes, anything else you could name. COVID got way too much attention. Let Jesus Christ the healer receive all the glory and all the attention from this day forward. No. Even disease that people can't see or they don't understand. You know what? Mental disease is just that. And you shouldn't have to be ashamed of it. And you can ask for healing for it. And you can believe for healing for it. In the name of Jesus, I speak healing over stress and anxiety. I speak healing over whatever wounds are causing those symptoms, whatever trauma has happened in our lives that tries to leave just a gap open for the enemy. We close those doors. Those wounds are healed by the healing power of Jesus Christ. We receive it in the name of Jesus. And Lord, I just want to pray as we just trust you for your protection, for your healing. Will you do also what your word says? You said that you will satisfy our desires with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. Whatever season of life we're in, God, we want to be strong to do the work that you've called us to do. So would you satisfy our desires not with things that aren't good for us? There are things that they don't seem that bad on the surface, but if they kill our time or they kill our motivation or they affect our health, help us, Holy Spirit, to be satisfied with your desires. Again, let reading your word be just a joy that sustains us. And let prayer be something that we know, even if we aren't feeling it, we know we need it. And just let us be satisfied with the good things of God. And in so doing, we're shutting down access that the enemy could have to our mind or our soul. We're shutting all those things out. And thank you that you've made us clean. You've made us pure. Keep us that way, I pray, God. Keep our children protected from all the lies and just the disgusting things in this world. Keep their hearts satisfied with good things. That's what I pray over our children, our grandchildren, that they would desire the things of God. I'm praying for people who are addicted to nicotine, addicted to cigarettes or tobacco products. That's one of the most addictive things. Don't let them feel condemned because they're struggling with quitting. It's hard. But Lord, I'm asking for those who really want to quit, let it be a disgusting taste in their mouth. Let it be repulsive to them so that they're only to help them, Holy Spirit. You've had to help me with things. Let those that are addicted to sexual sin, let them be set free in just finding love in you. In realizing that anybody that they might be lusting after or having impure relationships with, God, that person is your child, and they would begin to value other people. They would begin to they would see that this is not just about an impulse or an urge. It's a deeply spiritual thing, and that they would be set free by the power of Jesus Christ. I believe you, God, that you can set us free from all things. And I believe you that you came to set the captive and the prisoner free. And I also believe that whoever the Son sets free is free indeed. If you believe that, would you just worship Jesus for a moment? Thank you, God, that you are able, that you are willing, and that we receive it right now simply by faith, not by feelings, just by faith in you. By faith in Christ alone, we receive it, we believe it. In Jesus' name, and all God's people said. One more time, would you just lift some praise to God? Glory to your name. Glory to your name. God bless you, church. I love you so very much, and I hope you know God loves you even more than I ever could. and he is with us and going with us. What a way to start our day. What a way to start our 21 days of prayer. I hope you'll come back tomorrow and invite some people today so they'll come back and be with us in the morning. Thank you to those watching online. We love you. We're praying for you as well. I've already seen some requests coming in online, and I want you to know we commit to be praying for you, for healing, for deliverance, whatever you need. We know the one who can meet all those needs. In Jesus' name, God bless you. Go with God. You're dismissed this morning.